welcome back to Let's Play EverQuest, Project 1999. I'm the RPG chick playing Incarnis. I have just reached level 16. and gotta get spells, and doing a bunch of different places this time. A few of them are research only, unfortunately. I'm not going to be doing research, but if you happen to want to do research, I believe it's Killith and Nightweaver sells the... Where is this? The Book of Dark Bindings. If you wanted to start research. Cat's Eye Agate, though. She does sell. I'm going to buy a bunch of those because I need that for my shield skin spell. I've been saving them when I have them. I think I sold one or two by mistake and then realized, whoa, level 16, we're going to need these. So, it's 2 gold. I'll just buy 20 of them for now. So I end up giving her 4 plat. Stick them here. This thing, somebody gave to me for letting them in the city. Kunzar cloak? Yeah. It's pretty awesome. +2 intelligence and wisdom. And +10 for save fire. Unfortunately, erudites, humans, and... Is it half-elves? I think half-elves can't use it. For whatever reason. I don't know. And it's a small item, right? Size small. Even trolls and ogres can use it. So, I cannot equip this thing. If I wanted to sell it to the vendor, it would be 82 platinum. I'm going to try to sell it in East Common Lands eventually. I've seen that it goes for around 150 platinum. So, make myself an easy 60 platinum if I find a buyer. And that's at some point. I am about to be leaving this city, though. These are the two guys? Okay. Bunch of the spells are sold by this guy, Divinius. The level 16 spells. He sells Cure Disease, which is rather cheap. Heart Flutter, which is expensive. Infectious Cloud, which is even more expensive. You know, I should have this thing off. Hold on. It's probably not going to change that much. And, you know, if I really wanted to go all out, I could take off all this flayed skin stuff because this all gives a minus to your charisma. But I'm not going to do all that. Okay, so I got Infectious Cloud, right? And then Shield Skin. Which is a little cheaper. And Spirit Armor. So he only sells these 5 spells out of 12. Unfortunately. And yeah, I've looked up the spell list and seen what he has and figured it out. You can go to this guy. Nidoral. For 2 more. He sells Cancel Magic. And Shielding. You see him spending like a small fortune on these spells. Okay. Now the others are down in the... Shadow Knight Guild. Let me through. Boop. Oh. No, actually. Head the wrong way. It's down here. These guys are hunting guards and dying a lot. Not sure what's going on there. Okay, it's here that you want to go to. The Fellblade. What's the guy's name? Sharas. Her name. Okay, so she sells the pet, which is Restless Bones. And Feign Death, which is very important. Obliterating my platinum here. Well, I have a lot more in the bank, though. So there are a few other spells. Banshee Aura you can find in two places. I think it's either West or East Cabalus. And in the over there, there's another merchant. So you can go to Kunark for that spell. If you're a lizard or if you have faction with them. I don't think it's that easy to get faction with them at all. And there's Voice Graph, which allows you to speak through your pet, which is basically useless, I guess, except as a gag type thing. There's Hungry Earth. I forget the other one. Hold on a second. Actually, it's just those three. It's Voice Graph, Hungry Earth, and Banshee Aura. But you can find Banshee Aura over in the Kunark continent if you really desired. So, these spells I'm going to put in my spellbook. Okay, so you want to see the difference between lesser shielding and, well, shielding. Here's my stats here, 289 and 289. More stats here. And it's about to fade out. So when it does, I'm left at 261. But, I didn't memorize that. Let us get regular shielding here. Not going to be using that anymore. Minor anyway, or lesser rather. Nice, up to 307. And I have over 500 mana. I think that's pretty good for level 16, don't you? And what else? Feign Death is fun. It's my first time using Feign Death since like 02. I have fallen to the ground. Which is the one that lets you zoom around. Now, how often can you use this? I think you have to hit stand or something. Sit, okay. Okay, you can use it pretty often. I thought there was like a long delay. I know monks have the ability. Maybe there's a longer delay with them. But yeah, everyone thinks you're dead when you do this. Indifferently. And regards as an ally. That's how you can tell. They think you're dead. They don't care about you anymore. One way or the other. Which is great. So that's your get out of jail free without actually dying. I've got Restless Bones. I don't know how good the Heart Flutter is. I don't know. So I'm curious to see. I got shielding on. Spirit armor. Can we use at the same time? It can actually buff other people's AC, which is one of the rare necromancer buffing spells that, you know, isn't completely selfish. So let's see if it works. What is my AC here? 265? It did not take hold because I have shielding on. Okay. These are spells that I can basically use on other people. I think even cancel magic you can use on other people. Now, the thing with cancel magic... Yeah, target. Dispels magical effects from the target. If I remember it right, it dispels the top one. So, actually, let's try it. What I used to always do is... buff myself with some buff that I didn't want to use, or I would put on after, and then basically buff myself down the line here and leave the top one open, so when I get poison or disease or something like that, I just cast cancel magic on myself and get rid of that. Of course, if they debuff you with two different things, you're kind of out of luck, but it's really depends on, you know, the circumstance. Cancel magic. Fizzling. Yep. It gets rid of your top spot. That's what it does. Alright, so I threw that thing in the bank and I'm going to gate out of here. I'm going to take a look around Tox Forest. There's a couple people that, or things I want to go check out. One of those rare cases of gating to somewhere else in the zone. I am leaving shortly for Antonica Continent, but there's a few things I have to take care of here. Or rather say, a few things I want to take care of. I'm casting Gather Shadows because I don't want the erudites from ones from Eriadin to be able to see me. And where is that? Here. One easy way to tell. Indifferently. Now the thing about this zone... Oh, number one, the undead can see me. But I have feigned death just in case of anything. There he is. Is that him? Rungupp. I think he's really lower level than me. I mean, he is, obviously, but... Oh, yeah, he's really easy. Now we've got a troll head. 1 pound. I'm not sure what we can do with this. I think it has to do with several quests. But, I don't know. Well, these are mountains. Well, who's this? Regards me indifferently. Verisha Fathomwalker. Who are you? Will she talk to me? Hale? Hello, Incarnis. I fear I didn't have time to speak with you as I am working my shift. Please contact me at a later time. Your shift? Now I'm being a little fearless here. He's blue to me. I think these can be level 15 or 16. Ooh, what's this? A pixie? Oh! Really? Should I fear kite this? Should I fear kite the pixie? I don't know. Resisted? Eat blood. So cute, though. Look at that little thing. Aww. Fairy and pixie got worse. That's pretty cool. It was actually pretty easy fear kiting that. Although I have very low mana at this point. Maybe I should just get some mana back. So it's actually so funny because I intended on leaving at level 8 once I got Gather Shadows, and then pretty much discovered the Warrens and was getting a ton of experience and lots of money turning in the gnoll teeth, and I would find bronze weapons sometimes. Not the gnoll teeth, the kobold teeth, and I would find bronze weapons on the kobolds as well. Pretty often. But now it's pretty much dried out. I have to go really deep in the dungeon at this point to get some experience. And things that are lower than you, as in they're green enough to you, not dark green. You won't get the special items from them. You won't get the teeth, or I'm not sure if they'll even drop the bronze weapons either. So it's pretty much keyed to your level. So I figured, well, let's tough it out. I made level 15. Let's tough it out for a level. I can still get some platinum and go get my level 16 spells before I leave, which I have done. So there's one more guy I have to see. He's a fisherman guy. And if we turn in his head or his belt or something like that. He's along the water here. I'm just not sure if it's on this side or across that bridge. Just looking out for the good aligned erudites. I've really forgotten so much of this zone. You can kind of see the other side there. And I'm sorry I'm jerking back and forth. I'm too lazy to use the mouse. It's kind of jerky. I mean, I could, but it's just, I hate it. I don't know. like going down there. I can't see who's on top. Now, they might not even attack me. I've gotten tons of faction. Even though every time I turn in a Kobold Tooth, I lose faction. So I'm not sure where I stand with these guys right now. All I know is the guards are much higher level than me, and I'd prefer not to die. Kobold Sentry. Yeah, green. Scout. Gotta be green. Yep. Is that bridge? I think we're gonna cross it. This guy might attack. Kobold Runt. Now this should be the bridge. Oh, he's gonna aggro my pet anyway, even if not me. Thank you. Let's see, who's at the other end of this bridge? Is this the bridge that goes to Kara? Who's this? Eridan Emissary glares at you threateningly. Alright, you know what? Where's that spell? What's that spell? What's that spell? I think this kills my pet, though. Yeah, because he thinks that, indifferently. He thinks that I'm dead. Or gone. Otherwise. There he is. Okay. He's still on the heretic side. Past the bridge. Basically, Eridan's that way. Continues that way. The bridge is over that way. So, Aglthin Dinsmore. Dasmore. I don't know why I keep saying Dinsmore. I believe he's level 8, level 10, something like that. So, shouldn't be much of an issue. See his pet die. Missed that. Fishing pole. Now I'm going to gate back. losing my shielding here. Now if you want to take a look at this thing. You can actually use it for fishing if you wanted to. Okay, it's this guy. So would you judge yourself an experienced heretic and one has much to learn? If you say much to learn, this is the guy they're talking about. I'm easy to read this way. There's an old and frail erudite male who now lives in Toxxulia named Aglthin Dasmore. He has left the ways of Khazad-dûl and no longer practices our craft. He has been stripped of his power and wealth, so he spends his time fishing by the river. Our great lord of fear has decreed that his life is forfeit. Slay him and bring me proof of the deed. Good riddance to him. Here is something useful for you in order to continue serving our lord. So this is the staff of the Abattoir Initiate. As you can see, it gives you intelligence plus +1. Other than that, damage 6, intelligence 30, attack delay 32. And that's it. Usable only by erudite necromancers only. Although, you know, is it better or worse than what we have, which is the rune bokken, if I'm saying that right? Is it better to have all those plus +3s for saves across the board, or is it better to have plus +1 intelligence? I don't know. And it's damage 9, 37 versus 6, 32. I think the rune bokken is better. And lore item no trade, which means we cannot sell it. But what about this troll head? I'm gonna put the staff in the bank, actually. I want to see about that troll head, though. Okay. The quest for Rungupp, actually, is, well, you need to do it from gate callers in Eridan Palace. I don't think there's anything here you can do with the troll head in Peniel. They give you 10 gold, I think. Wait, let me see. Yeah, we get 10 gold from Vasil Janir and possibly a fire flux spell. And it says, among the possible rewards. So, what if you tell this guy? Experienced. I spelled that wrong. Experienced heretic. In Karavidge, there's a particular cat named... Oh, you can get a free bag this way. Named Kira and Mira that we've been using to gather information about... Well, certain aspects of cat society is no longer providing information for us, and we have something for him that we may encourage him to assist again. Hand him this sealed bag for us. It may just change his point of view. Let me guess, it's containing someone's sealed... Well, I can't even... Well... Hold on. It's a sealed bag. A smelly sealed bag.